Yeah, welcome to another episode of Darkskies Podcast, coming to you live from Los Angeles, California, from the Bay to LA, all the way to San Jose, down to San Diego, up to Sacramento. Yes, indeed, going deep into the night. Tonight, we're having a Halloween special. Finally, it's here. Talking Halloween. Yes, indeed. We're talking top 10 most haunted places in the world. Ooh. Well, hope you don't scare easy, right? Because we're talking, scary places. So I'm going to give you a second to get yourselves comfortable. Light them if you got them. We'll be back in a few seconds. We'll do a scan. Thank everybody for joining us for another Darkskies Podcast. And today's going to be fun because we're going to be doing a Halloween special. Today we're talking about some of the top 10 most scariest places in the world. And just in time for Halloween. Yes, indeed. Darkskies Podcast. Handing out the gifts. And the gifts are scary stories. Most haunted places, top 10. Man, it's going to be crazy, y'all. But this is what we do. And I'm excited, too. Anytime we do stuff like this, is right up my alley. So, without further ado, let's get the introductions out the way so we can get this show going. I'm your host, LC Grace. Thank you. I see Mikey and Axe over there. Jim sitting right in front of me. Yes, indeed. I see Becky over there on the ones and twos. Yes, whole crew together. And we're going deep into the night and we're talking, wow, Hollywood. It's like a Hollywood story. All these crazy places and haunted, you know, areas where people go and they do stories about, they make movies about them. And is all this stuff real? Is ghosts real? Are haunted places, you know, what's going on there? You know, is it negative energy or is it just our imaginations? What makes people see these crazy things? Specters and spirits and shadow people. Well, we're going to take a look at some of the haunted places here in the world, and there's a little bit of the backstories behind them, and just to try to get into the Hollywood mind state, you know, because Hollywood really gets into these things, right? Because they research these places, they go to them, and then, you know, in order to make these movies. But what about the people who actually live at these places or lived at these places? I don't know. So many stories. And they're all scary because when you hear about sounds in the dark, bumps in the night, things moving without, you know, nobody there to move them. The night air. Well, it gives you something to think about, right? You know, what's in the darkness? What moves just beyond, you know, our vision? Well, we're talking the top 10 most haunted places in the world. And one of the first ones we're going to visit is one that very famous. And like I said, a Hollywood mind state. Well, did we have going into this? Well, they definitely did their research on this one. And out of the most horrifying places in the world, one of the most scariest places that came up on our list as we started researching this topic is the Amityville House, also known for the movie called The Amityville Horror, for some of you who've seen it and some of you who haven't. Can I spoil that movie for you? It's a scary ass movie about a house that, man, a lot of crazy stuff happened in, and it ended up being just a place for just negative energy. Ghosts, specters, all kinds of type of events that happen at this place. It's mind-boggling. But let me get you to the backstory. Let me tell you a little bit about the Amityville House. First of all, this house is located on 112 Ocean Avenue in Amityville, New York. And, it's an upscale Long Island suburb area in New York. And this was the site, of many different stories, right? Scary stories, different people telling about, what happened. And, it's mind-boggling when you start to ask yourself, is this true? What did people see when they were at this place, at this home? What actually went down? To cause, the people, well, nobody didn't want to live there. Now, everybody like, forget that, man. But anyway, the story of what happened was that the home, this house was the site of a brutal family murder. And the story says a 29-year-old man named Ronald DeFeo Jr. Am I saying his name right? DeFeo Jr. Anyway, the story says that he shot and killed his parents and four younger siblings. And this was said that, of course, the date was November 14th, 1974, so we're coming up on the anniversary on November 14th, a couple of weeks from now. Ain't that scary, y'all? For it to be a Halloween show, and we're doing this show, we're talking about the Amityville House, of course, that the movie Amityville Horror was made out of, and basically the movie was about. Basically, what the story was, the young man basically lost his mind and killed his family members, each one shooting them. So it's just negative energy, right? Negative energy in this place. I don't know. I do know. I remember seeing that movie, and that movie was so crazy because I remember thinking that, man, if I lived in that house, I would have to get out of there. I could not stay there. And it was like, why would those people want to stay there? But anyway, November 14, 1974, but the place was crazy, because the legend surrounding the home stemmed from the family who moved. And a couple of years after the murders, and basically George and Kathy Lutz and their four children. Now, they were known for the tragic events, that happened at the house, and they still agreed to see and take the property. So, including 4,000 square foot house, waterfront access. It's a beautiful place, right? boathouse, heated swimming pools and garage, had the full basement. You know, sounds like a good deal. A beautiful home, family home. So yeah, they bought it and you know, they moved in. Kathy and George, you know, started to enjoy their new life in their new home. And this is where the story starts to really get strange, as if it wasn't strange enough, you know, with the family that stayed there before and, you know, the young man losing his mind and killing all the family members. And it's crazy because, you know, all these spirits in this house, you know, they remain. So, of course, Kathy and them didn't know it. You know, Kathy, the mother of, you know, wonderful mother, she got her children there and they all living there. And it's funny because as soon as Kathy said, as soon as she walked into the house, this is a statement that was released from her. She said that she had a smile on her face, you know, and it just beamed. It hadn't, you know, it hadn't happened in all the previous homes that they looked at. You know, it's like this house was just calling for her. Like she just loved it. You know, so this is, you know, the events that she was recalling when they first saw the house and wanted to move in. And of course, they went on and got it and moved in. So started the events. You know, all the paranormal events started occurring. And I know from what I seen in the movies that, you know, some of the stuff that was happening, I would have definitely moved my family up out of there. But, you know, some people don't believe in ghosts. You know, some people don't believe in specters. But, man, it's crazy because, you know, they say, you know, soon after moving in, you know, things dramatically changed. And after having a place blessed by a priest, because, you know, things was crazy. And they like, their friends was like, you know what, have a priest come by and just bless the home. So they were started experiencing even more stranger things, banging noises in the dark, footsteps late at night, untraceable to any family members. Like nobody's moving around. Who the hell is that? You know, mysterious and just horrible odors. You know, like what the hell? Like where's the smell coming from? And you know, this is all happening, you know, like inside the home and there's no accounting for it. It's like, so it's like a green, like, I remember them, they were reporting a green, like, jelly-like substance leaking from the walls. Toilet water running back, swarms of house flies flying all over, you know, eye piercing and, you know, inside and outside of the windows and, you know, just insects, and it's just a whole, you know, it's like the list of things that was happening is just endless. So the family behavior even started to change. You know, they said George was often sick and went days without bathing, lost all his weight, while Kathy had constant nightmares. You know, every night she slept, you know, wake up, you know, cold sweats and from just having horrible nightmares and sleeping in that place. And the children began to fight with each other, couldn't get along, arguing, and just, you know, the whole scene just became so disturbing and the situation would worsen over time. And they decided to leave the house temporarily, but the night in which they were gone and turned out to be their last night there. Although George is reluctant to explain the full details of that night, the last night that they were there, the hardest thing for those people who experienced the haunting is the loss of being able to communicate with anyone else about it. You know, just being able to tell people what the hell happened that last night that they were there. You know, not, you know, they're not talking about it as openly as, you would expect somebody to want to get this off their chest. And it's hard to understand, why they wouldn't, but I guess it must have been horrific. But man, when stuff like that happens to you, man, I can just imagine, it's hard to dismiss, things that you've seen. It's hard to let it go. But of course they tried to have the house blessed. Remember that part of the movie, Get Out? The house didn't want to be blessed. But anyway, I just remember, man, it was a real crazy story. And the movie just left even more questions. But man, Amityville, that's one of the most scariest places on earth. So scary that they made a movie about it. Now, another place that we're going to talk about is Eastern State Penitentiary. Now, this place is super haunted. It was built in 1829 with the castle-like walls and imposing guard towers. Eastern State Penitentiary is in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and basically was the first prison to institute solitary confinement. Now, basically, solitary confinement is locking a motherfucker up by himself, letting him get over his mental problems. A lot of people in jail, they go crazy, start attacking each other, or maybe, not following the rules of the prison, maybe fighting, all kinds of different reasons, it is to punish a prisoner who's in prison being punished. So, being bad in a place with bad people. But anyway, solitary confinement separated him from the rest of the prisoners so he could, think about what he just did or what he's doing or, or get himself right. But anyway, solitary confinement drive people crazy. A lot of prisoners lost their mind, being left alone. The eating alone, being separated from all the other prisoners. So, man, that was crazy. But anyway, when an inmate left his cell, a guard covered his head with a hood and said it remained in confinement in the dark, so you couldn't see nothing. So out of the solitary system was quickly discarded due to overcrowding in Eastern State Penitentiary. It widely believed that it was the cause for mental illness among a lot of his prisoners, and operated as, and well, basically this place operated as a regular prison from 1913 until it closed in 1970. So during which it time it housed criminals like Al Capone, bank robber Willie Sutton. And the prison was abandoned in 1971. Rumors of strange happenings plagued the Stone Penitentiary since the visitors to the prison, sounds and footsteps and screams, So Eastern State is now a museum and Hollywood haunted house report, and they still get reports of footsteps in the yard, sounds, piercing the cells, and eerie noises and lonely walls that drift through cold, dark corridors, cell blocks. And cell block 12 is famous for its dismembered laughter. Is that right? Dismembered laughter? Mikey, did you write that? No, I wrote that. Oh, disembodied. Well, disembodied laughter. Well, I guess you hear the ghost laughing. Why did you just write that? That's what I would have wrote. But anyway, it says that the guard towers appear some nights to be occupied by shadowy figures. So you look up and see the guard towers, and they're supposed to be empty, but you see movement. Like, damn, what the hell is up there? Ain't no telling. I'm not gonna go up there to see. Well, another place on the list is the Edinburgh Castle. Now, this place, with some 900 years of history behind it, it would be almost a surprise that Edinburgh Castle wasn't one of Scotland's most haunted sites. But since its construction as a military fort in the early 12th century, the castle has witnessed a surprise attack, executions, and even a brief capture by English. The English is coming. The Redcoats came and took over. Anyway, they said they reincarnated as a tourist attraction. The Edinburgh Castle now offers haunted tours. So basically all the stuff that happened over the years, this place is super duper haunted. And now they just offer tours and they bring people through and, you know, you can take a look and experience the scary sights. And once it was hosted by the Duke of Alexander Stuart. Or is that right? Duke Alexander Stuart of Albany? The Duke of Albany. So anyway, they said he escaped stabbing. Is that right? They said, yeah, that's crazy. They said he escaped stabbing by stabbing guards to death and then burning their bodies. The hell? I'm sorry. I mean, because the stories at some of these places are just crazy. Lady Jeanette Douglas of Glamis. Am I saying that right? Glamis? They say accused of witchcraft and burnt at the stake. So these are some things that, you know, they said that happened there. And an unnamed piper was once wandered down and the castle underground passages and was never seen again. So they got passages under the, why would you go down there? I don't know. Anyway, this guy went down there, an unnamed piper, obviously unnamed because don't nobody know who the hell he is, and now they don't know where he at. Never gonna see him again probably. Anyway, in 2001, Edinburgh Castle became the site of one of the largest paranormal investigations in history. A team of 9 researchers and over 200 members of the public explored the castle's forgotten chambers. And think about it, the secret passages for this place is all these passages, and just, it's a castle basically, so you can just get lost in this thing. But anyway, they said all kinds of signs of ghostly happenings and weird noises could be heard. And weird things seem, you know, moving throughout the darkness. So the public is not told which areas of the castle was rumored to be haunted and were not. So 51% of the participants' haunted areas reported paranormal experiences. So 51% of the people who participated in this research reported paranormal experiences, while only 35% did so in the non-haunted area. So they said 35% of people in the non-haunted area and 51% of people in the actual haunted area. How do you determine which area is non-haunted and which area is haunted? I mean, I guess the stuff is happening in this area, but wouldn't the whole freaking castle be haunted? Wow. But anyway, they say that you witness things like shadowy figures and things to suddenly drop. And basically the temperature suddenly drops and gets real cold in certain areas of the castle. The feeling of something tugging on your clothes are always happening. These are everyday experiences here in Edinburgh. So one person said, so if the castle's paranormal activity isn't enough, Edinburgh also boasts the Mary King's Close. Now, what's that? An underground area of the city in which victims of the Black Plague was quarantined and left to die. Oh, man. Now, that's scary. Man, can you imagine just going to some of these places and just, you know, spending the night? With Halloween getting close, I know some of y'all may be interested in going to visit some of these places. Feel like going to Amityville? How about Edinburgh? Who knows, man? Right now, we're going to take a quick break. You're listening to Dark Skies Podcast, and we're talking the top 10 most haunted places in the world. Thanks for joining us, y'all. We're going deep into the night.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, players and pimps, we'd like to welcome you all to Los Angeles, California. Yes, sir. Running down the line, sunset and vine, blew a half a zip by the Hollywood sign. Scotty once said it gets better with time. East side Long Beach, but this LA County on mine. Yeah, this is the sign of the times, one of a kind, and this might blow your mind. This ain't no TV show, bow wow, yippee yo, standing on your tippy toe, nigga, here we go. Crenshaw Boulevard, everywhere, niggas hard, left on burning by my auntie's front yard. No disrespect or disregard. Shout out to the whole motherfucking Crip Guard. Dip hard, wreck hard, used to pop lock. You turn on the wrong street and you will get got. Rules of the city like V5-4. Creep slow in a 4, motherfucking 5-0.
Look, Dog Pound Gangster, we gotta dump off. Unless you wanna hear that pump call, watch who you talk on, and watch the different streets you walk on. I mob like a mobster, like I'm a monster. Don't make me approach you. Contraband in my hand with the homies from the land with a plan to expand and leave with 100 grand. With my pistol in my hand, just me, Daz, and Big Snoop. That ain't never kept out the loop. Is this the way you living? In the slant of the unforgiving? Man, beware how you living. So let me show you what we're living.
Turn the city into place you wanna be at. Them Dog Pound Gangsters, yeah, and yeah, New Biz at. From Figueroa to Pacific Palisades, iconic Hollywood culture. Blow it in the fray, blind by the sun rays. I put on my looks, skirt that sunset as a ride of smoke. I'm blocking 22 miles at that famous boulevard. Echo Park, Silver Lake, never smoked in my car. Treacherous scenarios, yeah, it's 4 lanes wide. SA's Asian, yeah, one time. History extended from Caesar Chavez. From prostitution, wholesaling, live on Sunset Strip with a black and white blind. Pistol on the grip, yeah, I'm taking no shit. You see us as we ride by, exit 405, now the bus getting live, we in LA.
Smoking on a fire screen tonight. Going deep into the night. You listening to the Dark Skies Podcast. And yeah, we're talking top 10 most haunted places in the world. Man, it's a beautiful thing, people. Can you imagine traveling the world, visiting some of these crazy sites? I don't know, man. I could check some of them out, but I don't know. especially when you get into some of these specters and ghosts and some of these weird things that seem to be, you know, here in this world and maybe transcended to another world or caught in between. Or what makes these places so mysterious and scary? Well, let's talk about this next place on the top 10 list. And we're not going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We're just giving you the top 10 in no real order. I mean, because I can't tell you if one of these places are more horrifying or haunted than the other. I can just tell you that according to a lot of places or a lot of people and a lot of stories, these places are truly haunted. And the next place on the list, Gettysburg. The battlefield, man. The battlefield of Gettysburg. Man, at least 3 days of fighting. Some of the most bloodiest fighting in American history. At least 50,000 young men died in this brutal conflict called Civil War. And I ain't talking about Marvel Civil War. I'm talking about the American Civil War. So, man, this place was so crazy. All these people died. So all these spirits, people say that this battle is continuously being fought over and over and over again by the spirits of these people. Man, so with so many young men killed so violently, man, how many spirits would be located right here? Man, probably tens of thousands, maybe. Many believe that this site was haunted by the fallen soldiers and they're unable to accept untimely fates. You know, that they can't accept being dead, that they continuously fight this battle in the world of ghosts, the ghost world. Who knows? I'm not understanding exactly, but people are saying that they see things and hear things, and it's just pretty crazy. So these restless souls are said to wander this Pennsylvania field searching for rifles and comrades and ammunition so they can continue this battle, unaware that the battle has been over for many, many, many years. Gettysburg Battlefield. People go there a lot, you know. That's just scary. Yeah. I wouldn't want to walk through there, but if I did, though, you know, I wonder if there's any souvenirs that you can dig up, like in the ground, like an old bullet, something like that. Man, I wouldn't want to go there and be trying to find something and then end up seeing something or hearing something in panic time. But let's move on to the next one. The next place on the list is the Myrtles Plantation. Am I saying that right? The Myrtles Plantation? Well, basically, it's a slave plantation. So this estate in St. Francisville, Louisiana, built in 1796 by General David Bradford. Now, it's considered one of the most haunted places in America. And some say, witnesses says that as many as 10 murders occurred there. And through allegedly, several ghosts are moving around these properties as, you know, spirits and sounds and specters. And it's just, when I say specters, it's just like you see something moving, but you really don't know what it is. It seems to be a person, but is it? Well, who knows? But some say that they've seen ghosts. And one of the most popular tales for this place is that the slave name, what's his name? Chio, who was a legend and goes, well, the legend goes, had her ear chopped off by her master for basically eavesdropping. So he caught her eavesdropping and chopped off her ear. So basically, the story says that she's allegedly sought revenge by basically poisoning a birthday cake in which he killed two of the slave master's daughters. And their spirits are also said to be haunted the plantation. Man, this is crazy. So according to the story, you know, Cleo was hung by fellow slaves. But it said by fellow slaves, not the slave owner. I never heard a story of slaves hanging another slave. But I guess this is a first for everything. But anyway, they say that this, the souls of these slaves and these people that were murdered and poisoned basically still linger around the plantation to this day. And you can hear the noises as they move around. And you can hear, like, voices in that distance. Enough to make you say, wow. Man. Well, I'll tell you one thing. I will not be going there. Spend no time on a plantation anyway. I don't even like the soup plantation. I don't like the name. But anyway, one of these places that I was looking on the list really blew me away because it's close to home. Welcome to L.A. Well, right next to L.A. is Long Beach, right? And now we got L.A., Compton, Long Beach. Long Beach, home of the Queen Mary. Man, who knew that a former luxury ocean liner and warship nicknamed the Grey Ghost, the Queen Mary, was purchased by the city of Long Beach in 1967, transformed to a hotel, became a popular tourist attraction, a meal, and a guided walk around the ship's paranormal hotspots. Can run up to about $100. Got $100, you can go visit the ship and walk around and hear the ghostly reports of sounds, and you can hear the engine room. They say the lady in white moves through it. You can hear stories of children who drowned in the ship's pool. You can hear stories of how the sailors died, you know, near the engine room and still hanging around. Spirits, sounds, ghouls. And it's funny, too, because the Queen Mary has a Halloween event every year. And they should be having one this year. I haven't looked it up, but I'm pretty sure they did. And I always thought that the Queen Mary was just, like the haunted hayride. You know, you go there, you have a good time. Wear your mask, it's like a Halloween party. Who knew that this place was actually haunted? But not just actually haunted. It made it on the top 10 list of one of the most haunted places in the world. So, man, ghosts, sailors, children. And they don't even say what the lady in white is doing. But I'm not going to ask her if I ever see her. It's crazy, man. But it is what it is, the Queen Mary. So you go there if you want to have some ghostly experiences here locally here in California. Southern Cal. Well, how about you in the UK? Let's see, what do y'all got? Y'all got the Tower of London, right? It made the list as one of the most haunted places in the world. It's crazy. Erected by William the Conqueror. Man, in the 11th century. So this former political prison and the place of execution has been viewed as one of the most haunted places in all of Britain. Ah, man, among the ghosts, They say filtering through this place, this has all kinds of ghosts. The spirit of Anne Baleen. Couldn't tell you who that was. The wife of Queen Henry the Eighth. Okay, then I can tell you who that was. The wife of Henry the Eighth. Now, I know you UK people like, come on, man, you should know that. Nah, man, I'm from Compton. How am I supposed to know who the wife of King Henry the Eighth is? I mean, y'all don't know who the wife of Jimmy from down the block is. I'm sorry, I'm just playing. But think about it, y'all. A haunted place right there in the UK for y'all to visit. It says she was beheaded in 1536. How about Lady Jane Grey, who was spotted by a guardsman on February 12, 1957, on the 403rd anniversary of her death? He said the 403rd anniversary of her death. Damn! And so, what about Sir Walter Raleigh? Let's see, first ghostly alleged spotted building, well, basically, he was spotted in the building, or the first ghost that was spotted in this building was Thomas Becket's in 13th century, I'm sorry. All the way back to the 13th century. How do they know it was Thomas Becket's ghost? Did they ask him, or was he wearing his clothes, or maybe he looked it like Thomas Becket? What do you think? I don't know, man. Sir Walter Raleigh. How do you know? They know who their ghosts are. They name them. And it's crazy. Lady Jane Grey basically spotted. They even had a date on February 12th, 1957. That's the actual date that Lady Jane Grey was spotted. Now, she died 403 years before. Yeah, I wouldn't want to see her after that. I'm sorry. 403 years, you're dead. Now I see you definitely a ghost. So, Tower of London. Wow. How many of y'all, people who, you know, in the UK, who listen to this podcast, you know, leave it in the comment box. Have you ever been there? I would like to know. Have you ever seen anything strange there? Is it really scary? I mean, the Tower of London don't sound scary. I never heard about it actually being haunted, but it's on the list. So, man, are y'all real specific about y'all ghosts? Like, I seen my ghost at 12:55, November 12th, 1938. y'all be real specific. Right here in America, they be like, man, I seen a ghost, man, like the other day. Or a long time ago. Seen a ghost a long time ago. Like, when? A long time ago, man. Yeah, they're not too specific here in America, you know. But it is what it is. But I know one thing. We're finna take a quick break. Spook 'em if you got 'em. You listen to the Dark Skies podcast. And it's like a Halloween special, man. Talking the top 10 most haunted places in the world. Trying to give you a little bit of information on each. Hey, visit them at your own risk. We'll be back.
Talking white. New money, blue hundreds, cold winners. us, crew summers, we winners, the crew of us. There's nothing better than living it with your brothers. New wheels on deck, no chill, we flex. New chicks, we sex, who's up, we next. It's a race till the finish line, till all my dogs eat like it's dinner time. We spend it on light toys, dodging them bike boys, flipping them pill packs, dodging them bike boys. We know the risk and the payoff. You only live once, so we never take a day off. Woo! Chop shops are the small change. Small gun with a long range. With the molly, made our own lane. We just here to get paid, we just trying to get paid.
You ain't talking about the money, what you talking about? Trying to get paid. Fuck what they say. I don't need no faves. All I need is blue faves. Dead presence, what it say. Moving up George Jefferson. Shopping sprees, I know you never been. Oh, these niggas hit. Had to hit him with the wave. First class talking 1A.
Yeah.
First class talking 1A.
Remember sleeping on the rooftops. Now what I'm driving, now the roof drops. No more skating through my tube socks. Young wild niggas like the Boondocks. The treasure's inside of the trunk. Help mama with the first of the month. Baby mama get to buy what she want. Baby sister get to buy the free lunch. It goes down when the poverty's up. Woo! See the differences. Had to get it, no privilege. Had to take it, no middleman. Just divided up the dividends. That's drug dealer discipline. That's how you reel a man. Woo! For that almighty dollar. I make the whole gang follow. Yeah. The only way to pop bottles, you gotta have the money and the power. We just trying to get paid.
You ain't talking about the money, what you talking about? Trying to get paid. Fuck what they say. I don't need no faves. All I need is blue faves. Dead presence, what it say. Moving up George Jefferson. Shopping sprees, I know you never been.
Yeah, you're listening to Dark Skies Podcast coming to you live from Los Angeles, California. Yes, indeed. And talking the top 10 most haunted places in the world. Man, I tell you one thing. I don't know if you believe in ghosts or if you ever seen anything spooky. Some things are just unexplained. Something dropped and you're like, what the fuck? Well, it's a crazy world we live in, folks. We're going to get into these last three. Why still enough energy in this body that we call LC? Let's see. They say the Welly House? The Welly House. Is that correct? They say even hundreds of government skeptics apparently couldn't refute the evidence that this home in San Diego's Old Town neighborhood harbors some crazy spirits and paranormal activity. In the 1960s, the U.S. Commerce Department classified the Welly House as haunted. They had to classify it as haunted. But enough people had to see that crap and be like, you know what? That place haunted. But anyway, the Travel Channel has also dubbed it one of the most, what America's most supernatural homes. And obviously, they're experts, right? Anyway, the earliest ghost was Yankee Jim Robinson, who was hung on the site in 1852 when James Welly built the house, which, you know, in the mid-19th century served as a granary or a courthouse for a general store in 1857. So basically a granary and a courthouse and a general store. It's like a one-stop shop back in 1857. So anyway, this is down in San Diego. So they claim that you can hear Robinson padded loudly through the halls. And Rayleigh and his wife are also said to inhabit the house, so they ghosted there too. So announcing their presence with cigar smoke and perfume, visitors have also reported seeing crazy, lifelike young girls in long dresses in a dining room. And that's enough to make me check out. But this is the Whaley House down in San Diego, California. These places are close to home, right? You know, San Diego's about an hour away the way I drive. Man, but I will not be driving there. Well, another place on the list, and this is the ninth place we're talking about, is the place where Donald Trump is kicking it. The White House. Are you serious? The America's most famous residence is allegedly one of the most haunted? Well, according to a lot of people, the White House is severely haunted. And some of its inhabitants felt such ties to some of the American powers that chose to linger and stay here long after their deaths. So some believe they could hear whispers of ghosts of Abigail Adams, the wife of John. That's so crazy. So does the laundry room in the East Room? Well, Dolly Madison's spirit likes to lurk around the Rose Garden. Man, you go to the White House to see the president, and you're going to see Dolly Madison's spirit? Man, I'll be freaked out. I won't go to the Rose Garden if I go visit the White House. And of course, Lincoln's bedroom may be the site of the visit of old Honest Abe. Man, much as I like Honest Abe, I don't want to see him. Especially not now. He's a ghost. Man, who knew the White House was haunted? How could the White House be haunted and they're in there conducting business? Man, you're conducting business with old Honest Abe looking over your shoulder. Man, that's something to get you nervous, I tell you that much. I'd be blown away if I ever see anything. But you're in the White House and you're the president. I wonder if Trump ever seen anything. Well, Trump, if you listen to this show, tweet out if you ever seen a ghost. Are you having late night conversations with Honest Abe? A meeting of the presidents? Wow, that'd be crazy. Well, the last place on the list is the Winchester House. The Winchester House is said to be super haunted. It's a mysterious house, and is it actually? But is it actually haunted? I don't know. The United States Department of Commerce, of course, certifies that it is. Boy, they can't wait to certify a place that's haunted, huh? U.S. Department of Commerce. Well, I mean, what do they have to gain? I don't know. But I'll tell you one thing. They'll tell you, hey, that place is haunted. But it's still one of the spookier construction projects in history. So after the death of her husband and child, Sarah Winchester, the wife of the riflemaker's sons. Wow, that's crazy. Consulted and she became the family had become or had been killed by a ghost of who. Wait a minute, I'm completely thrown off by this story. Basically, this is saying that somebody proclaimed that her family had been killed by the ghost of those who died of bullets from her family's guns. So basically, you know, that's real complicated. Because the Winchester, they killed a gang of people. So you say that everybody in your family is being killed by the ghost of all the people that was killed by her family's guns. Oh no, that's real crazy, man. That's a tough one. So anyway, Sid suggested that only perpetual construction of on her family's mansion could mollify. What the fuck? These spirits? Why don't you just say calm these spirits? I've never used the word mollify. Is that even a fucking word? Well, I guess it is. Mollify these spirits. Well, I would say calm these spirits, because all these spirits are not resting in peace, right? If they were killed by the bullets of the guns of the rifles, the Winchesters, right? And killing people all these years, and now y'all worried about the ghosts of all the people that were killed coming back. Damn, Sarah. So anyway, so that's why she ordered, the perpetual construction on the family's mansion. So this is a strange story, people. So anyway, workmen who labored on the property every hour of every day for 38 years, and 160 rooms of the estate built entirely without the aid of blueprints. Because you ain't gonna need no blueprints. You're just building. Like, you need another room? Build another room. Need another room? Build another room. So this is truly bizarre in so many ways. And it's creepy just for the fact that they were worried about something. Who knows? I mean, I can imagine all those ghosts are bothering you. Ain't no hell. Ain't no way. She just feeling guilty, I guess, for the guns. I don't know. But anyway, they say the creepy features of the place are like the staircase to nowhere. Doors that open onto brick walls. Like, you open a door and it's a brick wall. Man, or a staircase to nowhere. Man, 10-foot drops in a window with the edge glass, spider web, monolith. I don't know, man. I'm not understanding this story. The story is even stranger than the actual claim. But I don't know if this place is actually haunted, but they're saying that the Winchester house is haunted, and it's haunted by all the ghosts of all the people that was killed by the Winchester rifles over all the time. I don't know. That's a crazy one. I just think that maybe she just went crazy and started having rooms built onto this place, and for 38 years had them people working. But she had the money, so I guess she had to spend it on something. Man, 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 man. It's a crazy world. But that's more of a crazy story than a haunted place, right? But I guess you would have to actually live there. I can't tell that woman she ain't seen what she's seen. Man, man, man. I don't know. I don't know. Man, we finna get ready to take another quick break. Then we're gonna come back. And man, Halloween. How many of y'all are ready? I know I'm ready. So, light them if you got them. We'll be right back. Listening to Dark Skies Podcast, coming to you live from Los Angeles.
Time. They just trying to ruin it. Shout out to the fact that I'm the youngest nigga doing it. Cap on, brim, bend, Denzel, air time. She ain't trying to pop that shit for pimp. Okay, well, never mind. I tried to told you Drizzy still ain't nothing nice. Brace the saying you should quit. Cars saying fuck your life. Okay, now we out of here. Toodles to you bitches. And if you dolled up, I got the voodoo for you bitches. Yeah, I'm busy getting rich. I don't want trouble. I made enough for two niggas, boy, stunt double. Famous like a drug that I've taken too much of. But I never ever trip, just peace, happiness, and love. I got money in these jeans, so they fit me kinda snug. Plus the game is in my pocket, nigga, this is what I do. I'm about whatever, man. Fuck what they be talking about. Their opinion doesn't count. We the only thing that matters. Oh, so we do it how we do it. All up in your face, man. I hate to put you through it. I be up all night, whole crew's in here. Cause I don't really know who I'ma lose this year. Oh, man, I love my team. Man, I love my team. I would die for them niggas. Oh.
Drizzy say kidder, I'm a kidder. I got that kind of money, make a broke bitch bitter. I got that kind of... Wait, wait. Fixate. Which bitch you know made a million off a mixtape? That was just a keepsake. Bought the president, the Louis presidential briefcase. Never been a cheapskate. We got the Hawks, I ain't talking about the peach state. Man, for Pete's sake, scratch that sweepstakes. Fuck, I look like ho. I look like yes, and you look like no. I'm a bad bitch. I ain't never been a mixed breed on a diet, but I'm doing donuts in a six speed. M6 in front of M2. I see a lot of rap bitches on the menu, but I collect 100,000 at the venue and pop bottles with my team. Young money till the death
I'm
for me.
I'm about whatever, man. Fuck what they be talking about. Their opinion doesn't count. We the only thing that matters. Oh, so we do it how we do it. All up in your face, man. I hate to put you through it. I be up all night, whole crew's in here. Cause I don't really know who I'ma lose this year. Oh, man, I love my team. Man, I love my team. I would die for them niggas. Oh.
Can't even rock them shoes if it don't got a comma on the price tag, you know. I mean, but then again, who looks at the price tag, you know?
Oh yeah, we in this bitch. Oh yeah, we in this bitch. I'm about whatever, man.
Yes, yes, yes. Every night is like a party, right? We're doing it. All these Halloween parties here, Los Angeles, live, cracking, just jumping, everywhere. People walking around in their costumes, monster suits, superhero costumes, late night parties, clubs, everything's jumping. This is how the West Coast do it. So, yeah, I'm loving it. And we got a couple more days, right? You know, this is Hallow's Eve, you know, as we get close to Halloween, you know. Halloween, you know, they got the new movie coming out too. Jamie Lee Curtis, hey, she's back. Hey, and, you know, we're going to check that out. We're fired up about that. Hey, Halloween, Halloween, Halloween. And as it get closer, you know, it's the Samhain. So people are so fired up, right? You know, during these times, the Druids used to burn animals in hopes to see the future. You can see the future, right? But anyway, so many things happen in the past in so many different ways for people to celebrate this crazy, crazy holiday. I say it's the craziest of all holidays because it's the holiday where all the crazy people can go and do wild things, right? You can go look as crazy and wild as you want. And I done seen some of the wildest costumes and some of the spookiest faces and like I said, the superheroes out too. I done seen Captain Marvel, Spider-Man, and not too many Supermans this year. Or Wolverines. Maybe they'll come out tomorrow. But like I said, you know, as Halloween get closer, you know, more and more people are getting fired up. People are buying candy, people are buying costumes, Halloween parties are being planned, drinking and smoking and gathering and, you know, it's all good fun. And like I said, we did this show talking about some of the most haunted places in the world, top 10. And like I said, you can go visit to some of these places, you know, and some of them you can't. Me personally, I will not be going to visit any of them. Like I said, I done seen enough crazy stuff in my life. I don't want to go seeking more. You know, the streets of Compton, man, you know. The streets of L.A., South Central. Can you imagine? You know, there's a lot of haunted streets around here, haunted houses. And what's so funny about it, there's so many haunted spaces here in South Central, we don't even know it's haunted because we don't have time to stop and, you know, listen to a ghost. Like, I heard some footsteps. Gotta go, though. Or maybe we do hear stuff and we get on, but then don't nobody talk about it, man. If y'all got any stories about any haunted places here locally in Los Angeles, you know, leave a comment in my comment box. Let me know. Tell us where it's at. Maybe we can avoid it. But for some people, want to go to it. Oh man, it is what it is, man. I tell you one thing, I will enjoy this Halloween. Like I said, we're gonna check out the movie. I'm gonna hit up a couple of parties. We got shows coming up, but this is the Halloween show. But we got other shows coming up. But we just wanted to do the haunted places because, man, there's some scary places in the world. Who knew? Only when you start to talk do you start to realize that there's so many things that happens right above our nose or below our nose or on side or, you know, just out of our peripherals. Who knows, man? When I say that there's a such thing as paranormal activity and it's all over the world. And these are crazy because some of the reports, they reported odors, right? Some of them reported sounds. Some of them reported footsteps. Some of them reported seeing things. I mean, so all of the different places, all of these different paranormal activities being done by who knows what type of spirit, right? You know, some of these ghosts actually have names, and we know who they are. So it's just so fascinating, especially when you start to look at it from, you know, my perspective. I'm like, man, how do you even know exactly who it is? But, yeah. So, yeah, UK, y'all got haunted places. America, we got haunted places. All over the place, all over the world. Turkey, I know y'all got some places in China. Japan. There's places all over the world. Russia. There's some scary places everywhere. France, I know y'all got some. So, just leave it in my comment box if y'all want to share some of the most scary places as Halloween approaches. And have some clean fun out there, y'all. Get the scariest costume or the funnest costume that you can find. Go hit up one of your Halloween parties and, you know, just enjoy yourself. Because this is the best time of the year. As we get past Halloween, you know, we got Thanksgiving. We got Christmas. We got New Year's. So it's a lot going on. This is the time of the year where everybody's fired up. So let's stay fired up. I'm going to see what's happening on my side. Just the West Coast. I'm pretty sure there's a lot going on over here. I'm ready for it all. So thanks for listening. I'm your host, LC Grays. We got Mikey Knight still here. Jim sitting right there. And Jennifer and Becky. Both of y'all. Y'all both been tag teaming lately, huh? Oh, okay. Well, it doesn't matter. I mean, y'all do the music. I ain't tripping. I ain't. You know me. I'm just here to spread the word. Never change. But I tell y'all one thing. I don't know if you believe in ghosts. Or if you even got time to believe in ghosts. But when you hear something in the dark, or you see something move, what do you do? Do you run? Do you even tell anybody? Do you keep it to yourself? Do you ignore it? Man, I don't know, man. Me, personally, I don't see, like, ghosts and stuff. I mean, and if I hear something that's haunted, I kind of avoid it. I try not to be around that stuff, so I don't know, man. Everybody is everybody. So, like I said, let's have fun. Halloween is approaching, and we're going to have another show coming up later. Thanks for joining us. You've been listening to Dark Skies Podcast, coming to you live from Los Angeles, California. And we out.